Hannah Jones.
The Jazz FM Money Minute.
Well, there's more encouraging news for the UK economy, which returned to growth in the third quarter, according to the British Chambers of Commerce. Based on its survey of firms, the BCC says the economy grew by 0.5% between July and September. That's after three consecutive quarters of negativity. House prices will stay flat or drop slightly over the next year, despite a gradual recovery in the economy, according to the Nationwide, which has suggested that the Bank of England's new funding for lending scheme, aimed at boosting credit, could support the market. Prices fell by 1.4% in the year to the end of September, the Nationwide said. And shoppers have been descending on stores of the collapsed JJB sports chain that have been sold to rival Sports Direct, which has bought all the remaining stock and is now shipping it to the 20 shops it has bought. The 133 stores that weren't included in the sale have all been closed, with a loss of about 2,200 jobs. To the stock market with Alpari, financial spread betting on global markets, and the FTSE closed 11 points down at 5,809. I'm Johnny Hart.
The Jazz FM Money Minute. Jazz Travels with Robbie Vincent.
Jazz FM. Listening colour.
Vincent, Jazz Travels. That means travel, it means good music, blues, soul and, of course, jazz. Our guest is Harry Handelsman. Harry's firm built the Renaissance St. Pancras Hotel, and the hotel is artistically so interesting. The tours around it, can you believe, are nearly as full as the rooms that you book. Harry has a huge love of jazz, as he told us last week.
I think jazz to me is about emotion. It's probably the one form of music that you can have one or two instruments and it really touches you.
Harry's very proud of the St. Pancras station, the new styling and its throwback to those lovely days of steam trains that so many people like. But Harry, if we were to jump on board one of those trains, we could even go and look at another one of your projects, can't we?
What is quite interesting is if you do take the Javelin from St. Pancras, 6 minutes later, you arrive at Olympic Park. And there, very differently, what I'm doing there is I'm redefining high-rise living. And it's the first time I'm calling in a development Manhattan Loft Gardens. And the reason Manhattan, because it's of aspiration, loft, because some of the apartments are double heights, and garden, because I'm creating these magnificent gardens on the 8th floor, on the 26th floor, on the 34th floor, which are going to be absolutely fantastic. And each garden will have another function. Now, the purpose of them is not just create a piece of architecture, because I think architecture is really, really important, but I also believe that architecture has to be mixed with functionality. And I think what I want to do is I want to reintroduce the spirit of community in a high rise. And what I want to do within my building, I want to create opportunities where you can meet within the hotel, you can meet within the amazing spa, you can meet within the restaurant, but you can also meet within the gardens. And everybody will want to come to the garden. And then you can create a community, which I think is absolutely important.
So the gardens you have access to if you live in the block, they're not individually owned. Do you know what? I've just dawned on me. You probably won't have any slugs. How would a slug get all the way up there? And if you meet and talk to any gardener, pain of their lives is, I think, not weed and slugs. And the great thing is, if you lived up there, you wouldn't have any slugs. You're a genius.
Well, you see, I mean, and you know, the brilliant thing about it, that wasn't my main consideration, but now that you mentioned, I'm going to put it into all my marketing material.
And then we'll find they're pretty slow, but I bet you and I will discover that nature is far cleverer than we are, and we'll have high-rise living slugs. I'm absolutely sure.
But you know what? And they'll be very happy being there, you know, and they'll feel privileged. And you know what's wrong with being with a nice slug?
Robbie Vincent Jazz Travels, that means travel, and of course good music, soul, blues, and plenty of jazz too. My guest is Harry Handelsman, and we've been talking about Gardens in the Sky, and that was Garden Party from Mezzo Forte. The sighting of the high-rise home with garden in the sky in the Olympic area, is that because of the Olympics? Is that because the presence of the Olympics in that area, you think, has helped regenerate it anyway? Put your business hat on and tell me why you went for it there.
It's a very good question. And to be very honest, initially when the opportunity was offered to me, I said absolutely not. I had no interest in Stratford. I thought the whole thing was a big mistake. But that was before I went there. And really what I went there, and that was before the Olympics, that was in 2009. And all what I saw the skeleton of Westfield. I also saw the Olympic Stadium being constructed. But I think beyond that, there's much more of an infrastructure. There's the most lavish and elaborate garden being created over the last 150 years, 500 acres. I mean, that's absolutely amazing. And really what I wanted to do, I was quite interested in defining a new way of high-rise living. And I just felt, what would be better than to create an Olympic legacy by really introducing, and the reason I mention it's one of the best buildings, my brief to my architect, or SOM Skidmore Owen-Mell, which are the largest architectural firm in the world. You know, they built something like the Hancock Tower, the Burj Khalifa in Dubai, the tallest building in the world. I told him, look, I want to create a community, but also what I want to do is I want you to create me the best building in the world. I know the world is a big space and things might change on a daily basis, but at least for Europe. And I really think we have done something which is great. I think it's got essence. To create that legacy, I think will be fantastic.
And of course, you can get on the train at St Pancras and be there very quickly. You live in one of your own creations. I know it's near the Tate Modern. Who's got the most pictures, you or the Tate Modern?
Well, I have moved from my place adjacent to the Tate Modern. I lived there, I loved it, and I moved back to Hyde Park Gardens where I currently live. But it's also one of my own creation because what I did is I converted about 14 rooms into 6. So I did make a bit of a change to the structure of the building. And I do collect art. And I must say, on the last count, rather sadly, the Tate has a few more. But I'm trying to catch up.
Thank goodness he said that. And are you somebody who likes, because you can afford it, do you like to support new artists, or are you a traditionalist, or a mixture of both?
I'd like to support new artists, not because I can afford it, because I think there's an incredible talent out there. And I also believe that support helps. You know, I think at the end of the day, you know, established artists require less of that support. So I'm quite interested in new support. But what also makes the situation very interesting, having the privilege of owning the St. Pancras Renaissance Hotel, it gives me an opportunity to hang art in my rooms. You know, one of the things that I have a bit of a resistance to is buying art and putting it into storage, because I don't think it's right. You know, I mean, I don't buy because of increase in value. That's not really what interests me. What motivates me is being able to display and see the art that I like. So having St. Pancras and having 245 rooms and a number of them being very large suites, I do have opportunity to catch up with the Tate.
Robbie Vincent, Jazz Travels. We'll be back after the break with one of Harry's own choices. Pretty good one, too. It's Tom Scott.
Jazz FM.
With the latest traffic and travel news when you need it, 7 days a week.
I'm Simon Turnbee with the latest Jazz FM traffic and travel. There's delays in the Girvan area of South Ayrshire. The A714 is closed after a vehicle hit a railway bridge the other day from the A77 to Pinwall. So the diversion is using local roads. It is signposted. South on the M1 through West Yorkshire, you'll find queues of vehicles broken down from Flushdyke at junction 40 to 39 at Durker. It broke down at around quarter past five, closing the lane. The northbound side of the M6 through Cheshire is queuing because of an accident from junction 20 at Lym to 21 at Woolston, with queues backed in Knutsford at junction 19. And the anti-clockwise M25, very slow, junction 9 at Leatherhead to 7 at the M23, not being helped by the fact that a lorry broke down earlier at junction 8. If you spot any problems, call in if it's safe and legal, 0500 59 27 27.
Jazz FM's Listening Colour.
Hello?
This is Alexander Orlov. I would like to speak with your papa to congratulate him on choose his second toy after he renew his people's carrier insurance through comparethemarket.com.
Dad, there's a meerkat on the phone.
Give me the phone. What are you doing?
Oh, Sergei, the cheeky little puppy hung up on me. No respect. To collect more exclusive meerkat toys, buy your car or home insurance or get credit card to comparethemarket.com. Simples.
Jazz FM.
This is Chris Phillips, and this week on The Jazz Breakfast, you can win a holiday to the mystical land of Jordan. It's the home of Wadi Rum, the legendary desert setting for the movie Lawrence of Arabia, which celebrates its 50th birthday this year. Jordan is also where you'll find the beautiful Red Rose City of Petra, built into the walls with its famous treasury.
Just listen to The Jazz Breakfast with Chris Phillips all this week from 6 until 10 to find out more. And enter to win a luxury all-expenses-paid holiday to Jordan for two. All the details can be found at jazzfm.com whenever you want. Visit Jordan, taking you beyond with Jazz FM.
Now and again, a bit of experience comes in handy. Like when you're hand-making sofas to order. At DFS, that's what we've been doing for 43 years. So when you order a handmade sofa from us, you know you'll get exactly what you want. Come and see for yourself. With at least £500 off our new style collection sofas and 4 years interest-free credit, we think you'll enjoy the experience. But hurry, savings must end soon. DFS, making every day more comfortable. 0% APR representative.
What, unlimited movies?
Yep, unlimited music.
Yep,
unlimited TV and video.
Yes. TalkTalk Broadband is completely unlimited, so you can download, upload, stream, surf, all to your heart's content. The only thing that is limited is your chance to get it half price, because the offer ends October 10th. Essentials from TalkTalk, Britain's best value phone and broadband. Just £3.25 a month with £9.50 value line rental. Sign up to the deal that tops Sky, BT and Virgin standard packages at talktalk.co.uk. A brighter home for everyone. Minimum contract and conditions apply. Download speeds reduced at peak times.
Home. A single word that says warmth, security and happiness. It's no different for your Honda car. Bring your Honda home to the people who know it best. Us, your local Honda dealer. If you need a service, repairs, tires, or even an MOT, we'll match any quote from any garage. That's the Honda price promise. And we'll pop the kettle on. Visit honda.co.uk/price promise. Terms and conditions apply.
Jazz FM. This is Jazz FM.
Tall and tan and young and handsome, the boy from Ipanema goes walking.
He done quit his 9 to 5, he drink full time, and now he's living in a bottle.
Jazz FM's Listening Colour.
Bobby Vincent, Jazz Travels. That was Tom Scott and the LA Express, Tomcat. And that was a choice of our guest, Harry Handelsman. And Harry and his company, Major Movers, in the rebuild of the St. Pancras Renaissance Hotel. We have had in this country a history, haven't we, of wonderful hotels at railway stations. I mean, one of my favourites is in Edinburgh, where they still have the clock fast, because in those days they wanted to make sure people caught the trains on time. They still run the clock a bit fast. And there are other parts of the country where some of these wonderful hotels managed to survive in one way or another. But when it came to the Eurostar, I mean, this was as modern as it gets. How have you managed in your development to still retain some of that old-fashioned glamour of rail travel?
I think what is great about modern living are the conveniences, is the fact that you can get on a train at St. Pancras Station, and indeed if you stay in one of the suites, you'll have someone taking you actually to the train or pick you up from the train. So how glamorous is that? However, but I think what is happening is, yes, it's about convenience, but I think what is great about efficiency, speed, modern living is the anchor of old. When you arrive in St. Pancras, you're just overwhelmed. And you're overwhelmed by ingenuity. You're overwhelmed by something that was so aspirational, yet at the same time practical. You know, to me, I mean, I'm a great fan of the Eiffel Tower, but Eiffel Tower is a monument. It's a monument that today people visit. It's a monument that represents Paris, and for all the right reason. But what St. Pancras does, it's got a function. It gives you a sense of arrival. And also, to me, it, in a practical way, really represents the greatness of what Britain was in the 19th century at that time. I'm not suggesting Britain isn't great right now, but what I'm saying is this sort of imperial greatness, and not only the greatness in terms of wealth, but the greatness in terms of innovation, the greatness in terms of style, the greatness in terms of architecture, all of that is sort of encompassed at St. Pancras. And when you walk into the lobby, which used to be a taxi rank, again, you just look up, you look across, you look wherever you look, and you cannot be but pleased.
You love to go to Ibiza, but out of season.
Yes.
I know the island reasonably well. Okay. What do you find attractive about it? I mean, you don't go raving, do you?
No, to be fair, I used to do it, and I used to go, I mean, in the 80s, you know, when clubs used to be opening, blah, 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 in May, you used to go there, and you felt so amazingly cool. I mean, I remember one time I was traveling with Grace Jones. I mean, she was on the same plane. And it was just the most wonderful thing, because there we were about to land in Ibiza. And at that time, you know, the airline still had first class, you know, that, so we're sitting in the front, and there she was. And it was just wonderful, about to land. And before she gets out, instantly, for about 10 minutes, makeup, this, that, and then this glamorous smile of this woman coming out. And we end up staying in the same hotel, and she at the time opened the club. And then, you know, I spent, not only did I see a kind of less glamorous in the plane, super glamorous outside of the plane, and then I saw her body, beautifully glamorous all the time, made makeup or no makeup, sitting by the pool. I mean, what a revelation. How fabulous was that? And she actually did have an incredible amount of charisma and character and naughtiness, which was very enjoyable. And that, I think that is what Ibiza attracts. Ibiza doesn't attract the run-of-the-mill, perhaps in the summer. But off-season, there is sort of a sense of incredible snobbery by people that have homes in Ibiza, by people that go to Ibiza. And it's surprising how many of the cool people. Now, August, you wouldn't see me there. What I do is I rent out mine. I have a friend of mine who I saw yesterday, Uri Fruchtmann, who is a partner of mine at Ealing Studios and used to be married to Annie Lennox. And he has a home in Ibiza. And we saw each other yesterday. So, no. It is Ibiza in the winter, absolutely fabulous. I so love it. In August, I rent my place. I get a hell of a lot of money, and I so avoid it because I don't want to be there. Mm-hmm.
someday we'll be close together. Wait and see. Oh, by the way, this time the dream's on me. You'll take my hand and you'll look at me adoringly. But as they shoulder you cry upon, to see you through till you're everything you want to be. It can't be true.
Vincent Jazz Travels, Ella Fitzgerald, This Time the Dream's on Me, and there is somebody that even Grace Jones couldn't upstage. We're back after the break, we've got some more travel, and what would happen if we threw Harry out of London? Where do you think he'd go?
Jazz FM.
With the latest traffic and travel news, when you need it, 7 days a week.
I'm Simon Temby with latest Jazz FM traffic and travel. There's delays in the Girvan area of South Ayrshire. The A714 is closed after a vehicle hit a railway bridge the other day from the A77 to Pinmore. So the diversion is using local roads. It is signposted. South on the M1 through West Yorkshire, you'll find queues of vehicles broken down from Flushdyke at junction 40 to 39 at Durker. It broke down at around 5:15, closing the lane. The northbound side of the M6 through Cheshire is queuing because of an accident from junction 20 at Lym to 21 at Woolston, with queues back in Knutsford at junction 19. And the anti-clockwise M25, very slow, junction 9 at Leatherhead to 7 at the M23, not being helped by the fact that a lorry broke down earlier at junction 8. If you spot any problems, call in if it's safe and legal, 0500 59 27 27.
Jazz FM's Listening Colour.
Hello, Mrs. Ramsey. Congratulations on choose second meerkat toy after you renew your hardtop car insurance, so comparethemarket.com. I hope your little Bogdan is not make too much trouble.
It's not Alexander Orlov, is it?
Yes, he is. Yes.
Oh, my God! Oh. David! Come here! Quick!
Oh, Sergey, I think Mrs. Ramsey is attacked by mongoose.
David!
To collect more exclusive meerkat toys, buy your car or home insurance or get credit card, so comparethemarket.com. Simples.
Jazz FM.
Jazz FM with Moroccan Tourist Board, the country that travels within you.
My name is Faisal. I'm the PR manager of the Moroccan National Tourism Board for UK and Ireland. I will be your Jazz FM guide to Morocco today, and I will start my tour in Tangier, the main gate of Morocco and the main gate of Africa. During the 1950s to 1960s, Tangier attracted bankers, investors, authors, poets from around the globe. Tangier was the home of Paul Bowles, John Hopkins, and so many other artists. And even Tangier during the 1980s attracted famous singers like the Rolling Stones. And the Rolling Stones went to Tangier to be inspired by the diversity that the international status of Tangier created. So in Tangier, you have the music of the Reef Mountains combined with the music from Andalusia and Spain, with the influence of British music, American music, and African music. So Tangier is quite unique as a city. There is also a jazz festival, and every year Tangier turns to a city where jazz is the main music for almost a week. And the beauty about it is that when you see that Moroccans themselves interlate to jazz, and you can see that there is a jazz feast in Tangier during that time. When you think jazz, you think the US. When you think jazz clubs. But now, when you think jazz, and you go to Tangier, you will experience jazz in Africa, jazz in an international city, jazz on the streets, and it's completely different.
Rediscover Tangier and the variety Morocco has to offer. Visit jazzfm.com and travel for real.
See you tonight, love.
Okay.
Money's there for the car service at Vauxhall Masterfit.
Oh, right.
Oh, and grab me a lottery ticket with the change. Thanks, bye.
What? £100 and he wants change? That can't be right.
You really can get a fixed price service from just £99 at Vauxhall Masterfit. Carried out by expert Vauxhall trained technicians using only genuine parts. £99 fixed price service. Great value with no surprises. Well, unless you win the lottery with a change. To find out more and book online, visit masterfit.co.uk. Offer applies to an interim service for selected Vauxhall models over 3 years old.
Is Jazz FM.
In old Savannah, I said Savannah, the weather there is nice and warm, the climate's of a southern brand. But here's what I don't understand. They got a gal there, a pretty gal there, who's colder than an Arctic storm. Got a heart just like a stone. Even Iceman, they call her hard-hearted Hannah, the the meanest gal in town. Leather is tough, but Hannah's heart is tougher. She's a gal who loves to see men suffer, to tease them and thrill them, to torture and kill them. Is her delight, they say. I saw her at the seashore with a great big pan. There was Hannah pouring water on a drowning man. She's hard-hearted Hannah, the vamp of Savannah, G.A.
Robbie Vincent is Jazz FM, Jazz Travels. That's lots of travel and lots of good music too. Before the break, we heard Ella Fitzgerald, a choice of my guest Harry Handelsman. That Stacey Kent track, Hard Hearted Hannah, was another of his choices. Harry, you were talking to us about Ibiza and visiting out of season. Are there other places you would recommend us to go to that look different out of that busy period?
You know, very few islands of that sort. You know, when you go to Saint-Tropez, out of season, it's a ghost town. You go to Cannes. Cannes doesn't really do it for me. But, you know, places that are kind of small, you go to Mykonos. You go to places like that out of season. Ibiza actually has a vibrancy, which is quite exciting. The other place that does it as well is a place called Dea, which is in Mallorca, which is totally beautiful. And there too, it gets quite busy in August, but because of the beaches aren't as big and different, you know, there's a sort of a slightly different vibe. La Residencia, the hotel that Richard Branson used to own, is there. But
I didn't like the residence. Hmm? I didn't like it so much there.
When were you there?
I can't remember.
When Richard Branson owned it?
No.
It was different. I was there when he owned it, and I felt there was some authenticity to it. That when I think it's the I think it's the Orient group that bought it, which has sort of disappeared. I mean, I remember
it's changed that much. Hasn't
it? I think so, and I remember you. You know, when I was there, Richard Branson happened to be sitting, having breakfast, and, you know, bare feet and everything else, and say, Richard, do you mind if I talk to you about something? And I said, sure, come over. He said, look, I've got this amazing piece of property which you might want to invest in. You know, it was something called...
Well, what a surprise.
Called Port East Apartment, which was by Canary Wharf, which was a stunning Grade One listed buildings. And he said, you know what, Harry... I've been really successful in my professional life. The one place where I lost money was property. So I'm not sure if it's interesting, but he did open up a Virgin Cinema in my development.
You obviously love where you live. You haven't got quite as many paintings as Tate Modern. But I'm saying, ever so sorry, Harry, you've got to go and choose somewhere else in the world to live. Where would you go?
I mean, I think the first thing that I would do, I would probably travel. But if I would have to settle, bizarrely enough, I have a certain affinity to Tel Aviv. I have a sister who lives there. I go there about 4 or 5 times a year. And what I find about the city, I find there's an incredible kind of, especially of the last 10 years, because I love architecture. There's a great element and a fantastic element of Bauhaus architecture, which personally I love very much. And you see that. There's also a very good music scene. There's also some jazz scene in Tel Aviv. I mean, and it's slightly less predictable. So that might be something. If I wanted to be in a kind of more fashionable city, I probably would choose Paris, because I just find Paris amazingly beautiful. Country, its culture, its museum, etc., are so breathtaking that I do adore it. So it probably would be a toss-up. What is important for me, though, wherever I go... I think a city, I'm a bit restless. I think I need to leave a city in order to appreciate a city as well again.
And if you were encouraging, again, I'll quickly make you the tourist officer, if I may, for Tel Aviv. Why would you send us to Tel Aviv? Those of us who haven't visited it, why would you send us there?
Because I think there's a vibrancy that Tel Aviv has, you know, which I think is quite exciting. You know, everything is possible. And I think that there's sort of that kind of atmosphere that you feel. And you also have Jaffa, which is a part of Tel Aviv, which has a very strong Arab population, and I think you have sort of a mix of culture, which I think makes cities exciting. Thank you.
Guest Harry Hanselman, thank you. Wanted to hear a version, If I Were a Bell. There is one. That's Miles Davis. Now, Jazz Travels, very important news. It moves. It'll be this Sunday at 9 o'clock. And if you've ever wondered how you get yourself upgraded on an aircraft, or indeed find the best seats, or why people pay more money than you have, you'll find out all the secrets of air travel. That's next Sunday at the new time of 9 o'clock in the morning. Our guest is John Strickland. He knows all about that sort of stuff. After the news, it's Helen Mayhew and Dinner Jazz.
St. Regis Hotels and Resorts offers experiences that are beyond expectation and has jazz as part of its DNA. And the new St. Regis in Doha...